Hey, Betty Fish. 1st of May, 2018. No kidding, a Beyonce mass. There's so much, guys, that, like, I'm becoming overloaded that I want to share with you. So I'm going to just kind of, like, blast through a few things that I'll share with these articles and link them. And there's just so many profound things, not just in numbers, but I mean in just what is happening in this world. I can't put it to words. I'm not capable, you know what I mean? 9 journalists, 29 dead, 9/11s everywhere, pastors are worshiping Beyonce, suicide blast kills 11 kids. I mean, come on, you know, 9/11, 9/11. I mean, 23 were killed in Syria today. This is today, people. You know, this stuff is real, and it is happening. You know, and these things here that I show you when I relate to the numbers, it's only because when I see stuff, okay, my mind just sees it differently. And when I see something like this, I see instantly a 9 or 36 or 93. And it just goes into the back of my mind and I continue to look around. But when I start seeing patterns on the same very day, you know, 63 inmates, jailbirds, really, in love? I mean, all this is like back to back. There's my 36, 63. And to me, I see it as a 93. And the reason I see it as a 93 is because of George H.W. Bush is 93 years old. And this is crazy how this works with me, guys, but this is the way it is. 93 is the number of the lost word of Freemasonry, okay? I've been over this several times, and I don't get deep into it because, you know, most Christians don't want to get into this, okay? I was kind of just, like, formed this way. Spent some years in Freemasonry. I understand how these people work. That's all. And so I see a pattern pointing to Bush, who, by the way, they decide to put out an article yesterday just to tell us that he's staying in the hospital. That's the only reason. There's no other reason. It's just, oh, he's staying in the hospital. Okay? And on the very, very same day, they put out this article about a mass child sacrifice find in Peru. And if you look at this article, I mean, it's off the hook. They're talking about 140, exactly 140 skeletons, okay, in the mass child sacrifice grave. I see a 14. That's what I see. And then things start to form patterns. That's all. That's how it happens with me. So I see this 93, the 140, but when I see them talking about the sacrifice and about Bush and about the 93 popping up all at the same time, it's only natural in my mind to bring into my remembrance that this is, in fact, all being shown to us on a very high blood sacrifice, occult satanic ritual day, which was yesterday, which was the day they decided to tell us about George Bush and about 140 child sacrifices, which, by the way, if you read this, were between 5 and 14 years old, and their chests were ripped open as they were alive, and their hearts were extracted from them. Because that's what they do. It's what they've always done. They pull the heart out. That's the life. And so this stuff is all going on. And, you know, without getting, like, deep into the whole Masonic aspect of all this, because that's who Bush and all their ilk are. They're all just on the same satanic order. It's just the way it is, folks. You can't get around it. And the weird part about this is I noticed they did this yesterday, but it popped into my mind that we are 14 days away from Israel's 70th anniversary, the real 70th anniversary. And we see 140 skulls, 140 skeletons of children who were between 5 and 14. Do you see where I'm going? So I get this 14 thing. And when I start thinking about this stuff, it's just how my mind works. The Enochian calendar came into my mind simply because it was shown to me recently, and I still haven't, like, you know, put my stake in any calendar, to be honest with you. But this is pretty fascinating, because coming up just in a couple of days on the 3rd, we will have, according to the Enochian calendar, will be the 14th day of the second month. The 14th day of the second month. We all know what that is, right? And this is just crazy. And there's our 70th anniversary of Israel on the 14th. Okay? So, why does that bring us back to Enoch? Well, because if you look into the deep depths of Masonry, I mean, this is what they do, folks. Enoch plays a very, very central role in Freemasonry, in both the York Rites and the Scottish Rites, all Blue Lodge. Okay? And, you know, I've told you, I spent some years in Masonry, and, you know, I just have an understanding of how this works. And this is fascinating stuff. And of course, I'm going to link everything, but don't go into this stuff without the Holy Spirit, okay? Unless you're led into it. But it is absolutely fascinating. Solomon, Enoch, the foundations, the whole, I mean, it's really quite something. The Stone of Foundation, you can find about in the Apocrypha, Book of Enoch. It's absolutely fascinating. So, you know, I share it with you guys because I care. Plus, it just piles up in here that, I mean, if I don't get it out, I'm going to pop. And, of course, it brought a couple other things back to mind when I start looking at the calendars and I see the 14-day increments, the 140. I remembered a couple of weeks ago about the 1,400 sharks off the East Coast. Do you remember? That was right just on the 19th, a couple weeks ago. And the White House, remember the children, the 140 sacrifice? It was the 140th egg roll this year with our cute little Easter bunny. Remember the peeps? You know? So this all just starts to, like, form this pattern that it's showing they're building to whatever they're building to. And according to the Enoch calendar, this coming week or two is really quite fascinating, to say the least. So I share it with you, and that's all. I'll link all this stuff, but like I say, be careful going into this stuff, okay? It's quite tempting and luring. Now, I'm going to put that aside just for a second, and this is kind of related, but not totally. But it fascinated me when I saw it, about a guy who's getting out of prison after killing three cops, right? 70 years old, and his name is Belair, you know what I'm talking about? He's been in jail for 46 years, okay? And he's getting out, and these are the two cops he killed in New York. Look at their numbers, 32, 23, and 46. One black, one white. The separation's coming too, folks. It ain't just these Masonic demon devil worshippers that are at work. So is God. God is moving in fantastical ways. But you need to seek Him. You need to love the truth. You need to really, really want to humble yourself to understand and to be saved. You need Jesus. That's all. Because these things are coming. They're just being held back. Nothing happens without God letting it. So you want to be on His side. Okay? Come out of the world and know the truth of Jesus Christ. Hope this made sense to people. I hope you're all having a good week. Truly I do. Peace and grace to you. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,